thank you, dear friend, for coming back on EME Education Made Easier, a channel just for you. If you've not yet subscribed my channel, do subscribe the channel because there's a lot more to come and each video is definitely going to be beneficial for you. Today, I've taken up the poem Fire and Ice. That is the second poem from the first flight book of class 10. So this poem has been written by Robert Frost. Robert Lee Frost was born on 26th March 1874. He belongs to 20th century. But still he is different from other modern poets because he is modern in the spirit and traditional in the style of his poetry. Now, let me introduce the poem to you. Fire and Ice is a short poem consisting of two stanzas. These two stanzas deal with two possibilities of destruction of the world. How the poet has used the two elements, fire and the other with ice, both literally and symbolically, is worth appreciating. The title of the poem, Fire and Ice, is short and crisp but meaningful. It contains in itself the whole gist of the poem. Fire and ice are used symbolically for two contrary sets of emotions. Robert Frost shows the prevalence of fiery passions like fury, cruelty, violence, and greed, as well as of the cold feelings like hatred, indifference, and insensitivity. Now let me explain you the first stanza. The first stanza goes like this. Some say the world would end in fire, some say in ice. From what I've tasted of desire, I hold with those who favor fire. In this stanza, the poet Robert Frost states that there are two schools of thought holding contrary opinions about how the world would meet its end. Some people are of the view that it would end because of intense heat as there is increasing global warming. In other words, the deep heat or fire deep in the earth will lead to natural calamities like volcanoes, earthquakes, and tsunamis, which will one day end the earth. The sun may emit scorching rays and the world may burn down, but there are others who believe that the sun might lose its heat, leaving the world frozen to end. However, from his own experience, the poet subscribes to the opinion of those who think that the world would end in fire. Here, fire and ice have not been used only literally, they also have a symbolic meaning. Fire stands for fierce, fiery, and violent passions, whereas ice, on the other hand, is symbolic of cold feelings. Now let me throw light on the literary devices used by the poet in this stanza. The first one is alliteration. Alliteration is the occurrence of the same sound at the beginning of the adjacent or closely connected words. The example of alliteration is, some say the world will end in fire. So you see here, the sound of S and W are being repeated. Then look at the other line. I hold with those who favor fire. So here the sound of F makes the expression musical. Then let me come to anaphora. Anaphora is a poetic device in which a word or a group of words is used repeatedly at the beginning of sentences or clauses to create a special effect or to emphasize on something. So you see here, some say the world will end in fire, some say in ice. So here the expression some say has been used successively in two lines to emphasize the difference of opinion, right? Then the poet has used symbolism. Symbolism is the use of symbols to signify ideas and qualities by giving them symbolic meanings that are different from their literal sense. For example, fire is used as a symbol of anger, lust, greed, and violence. And ice is symbolic of hatred, indifference, apathy, and lack of consideration. Then we also have enjambment here. Enjambment is a poetic device in which
An idea does not end with a line. It is carried on to the next line or lines without any punctuation mark, comma, or full stop. So you see here, the first line is continuing into the second, and similarly, the third line is continuing into the last line. So this is the example of enjambment. The rhyme scheme of the poem. The poem is basically of 9 lines divided into 2 unequal stanzas, and rhyme scheme is not uniform, obviously, because in the first stanza there are 4 lines and in the second stanza there are 5 lines. So the rhyme scheme for the first stanza is ABAA. Is that fine? So these were the literary devices used by the poet in the first stanza. Here goes the second stanza. But if it had to perish twice, I think I know enough of hate to say that for destruction, ice is also great and would suffice. So in this stanza, the poet continues his idea that the world would perish, but the force of destruction is completely in contrast to the force in the first stanza. In the first stanza, we saw that the poet was supporting the people who favor fire. He thinks that people have lost all the emotions that were considered to be warm. They have lost affection, love, kindness, consideration, and even sympathy. These emotions have been replaced by the cold emotions of hatred and jealousy. So rampant and so intense is the feeling of hatred that the poet feels that it can be a potential cause of the destruction of the world. The end of the poem suggests that it doesn't matter which is stronger, whether the fire is stronger or ice. Both carry the destructive elements, which may finally annihilate the world. Now, let me throw light on the literary devices that are used by the poet. The first literary device that the poet has used here is enjambment, because you can see the thought of the second line floats to the third line, then to the fourth, and then to the fifth without the usage of any punctuation mark. So here the poet has used enjambment. Then poet has undoubtedly used beautiful rhyme scheme over here. As you can see, there are 5 lines in this stanza. So the rhyme scheme of this stanza is ABABA. Then we have assonance. Assonance is a close repetition of same vowel sounds within a group of words. Assonance occurs when vowel sounds, not letters, I repeat, not letters, are repeatedly used in a line. For example, but if it had to perish twice. So here the sound of I is repeated, which makes the line soft and musical. That's all for today. I hope you were able to understand the poem. For any query, you can drop in the questions in the comment section. I will revert back as soon as possible. Do share it with your friends, because I know your friends would definitely be grateful to you if you happen to share it with them. I will see you soon in another video. Till then, bye-bye.